Alrighty guys, good morning and welcome back to another video today. So storyline of today, we're gonna be trying out the new Shimano Vanford, which I picked up. I'll show you guys more about that here in a second. And we got some live shrimp in there. We'll be throwing that as well. Great way to test out a new setup is just grab some live shrimp and throw them around docks and mangroves because everything eats a live shrimp. Live shrimp are by far my favorite bait to throw just to catch whatever. So today is gonna be one of those days where we're just catching whatever bites. Now that could be snook, redfish, trout, it could be sheep's head, it could be black drum, it could be catfish. Very possible. There's a lot of things that eat live shrimp, and we're probably gonna catch most of them today. So I'll talk to you guys more about the reel here in a second, but we're gonna head up to our docks and get rigged up and get going, guys.
So when I was tying up last night, I started off with a circle hook, and I was prepared to throw a circle hook today because I didn't think it would be this windy, but since there is a little bit of wind, what I'm gonna do is use one of these little pink, I think they're meant for yellowtail, fishing yellowtail, but they're perfect for catching sheep's head and any type of fish that'll eat a live shrimp. They work just fine for that and holding the shrimp down to the bottom. Got ourselves a shrimp. I like to rig them through the tail just like that. That's good enough. And yeah, let's do this. So ideally we're looking to catch all species today. I've got a feeling we're probably gonna catch mostly sheep's head, but we'll take a peek around, look for everything. So this is the new Shimano Vanford. I think it came out late last year or midway through last year, not really sure. But this is the 2500 HG. I had a 2500 Stradic before and I fished it for about a year, caught pretty much everything with it. Now, I had zero issues with the Shimano Stradic FL, like not one single issue, not a weird noise, not any grind, like literally nothing. In a whole year of fishing it consistently, nothing. Now, I did take very good care of it, sprayed it down with fresh water every single time I used it. The reel never went, you know, 5+ hours or really without being sprayed down with fresh water. But this is basically, it's similar to a Stradic. I know someone can probably correct me in the comments or explain it a little bit better. But as far as I know, it's the same as the Shimano Stradic FL, but it's a little bit different material. So that makes it a bit lighter and it's just a tad bit more expensive. For the 2500, it was $229 for the Shimano Stradic FL 2500, the one that I previously had. I think that was $209. So I think this is $20 more than the Shimano Stradic FL. And it looks super sick with this setup. This is a perfect setup for your, you know, light tackle inshore. And it should be able to handle quite a bit. I've caught quite a lot. Well, I've caught a lot of big fish on 2500. It's probably a fish bigger than I should have been fishing with the 2500, but you know, I make it work. I catch all different size of fish, and a different size fish could come at any, literally any time of the day. I could go from catching sheep's head and I could hook into a 40-inch snook today. There's just, you know, no calling it. But this is gonna be my go-to setup for this year, as long as I don't lose it. And let's catch some fish. Got some on. Oh, what is that? Oh, that's what it is. All right, I'll take it. I was gonna say my shrimp got eaten instantly, but it's Jack. What is this? Oh! Oh, that is our second species of the day. I'm about to whack this pole here. Oh, that didn't sound good. Alright, second species of the day on the live shrimp. We got a Jack, and then we got a nice little mangrove snapper there. Now, these guys got to be 9 inches to keep. I'm sure he's right on the dot, 9 or 10. But, I'm gonna go ahead and let this guy go. Wait for a bigger one. Here's some. Oh! Came off the bottom there. And just like that, we've caught three species. Hooked them in the face there. Come here, buddy. Don't stab me. All right, three species knocked down. Jack, mangrove snapper, and now sheep's head. Nothing has been decent size, but I'm gonna toss this guy back into the dock here because there's a dolphin hanging out right next to me. You ready, bud? You better hide. All right. Well, we're catching some fish. Nothing huge yet, but I'll take it. It's a windy day, so at least we're catching something. I did it. Oh man, that was so weird. I was like, let me go throw this crab trap right here, and the second the shrimp hit the water, I had a fish on. I was like, what is going on? Why is there slack in my line here? And check out this guy. Whoop. This is the first ever triple tail I've caught from my Ginu. Look how tiny and cute he is. Little tiny triple tail. That was cool. It's like the second my shrimp hit the water, he must have been sitting right up on the buoy line there. Maybe we can find some bigger ones here. That's pretty cool. Surprised he's not yellow. I thought when triple tail are this small, they're usually kind of yellow, but he's not yellow at all. He's dark brown. All right, that's cool. Just kind of hoping we could find one of these guys today because I knew they sometimes hang out on buoy lines and stuff, but there he goes. Let me go back in there. Maybe he's got a bigger friend there. See if we can't find a real big one. So if you don't know anything about triple tail, long story short, they hang to structure and they really like buoys for whatever. Oh, they really like buoys for whatever reason. The shrimp is freaking out. Oh, got something. What the heck is this? Dude, we're catching every species in the book today. I think this is a, I don't know what this is, honestly. Y'all know what the name of this is? This is a type of croaker. Kind of looks like a hardhead croaker, but it's not. Let me know in the comments if you guys know what kind of croaker. I'm calling it a croaker. It looked exactly like a croaker, but it wasn't. Definitely wasn't a hardhead croaker. But dude, that is. We're just knocking out every species possible today. All right, switched over to a good old-fashioned Z-Man with a 3-0 weighted worm hook here. This should get it done for all these fish that are sitting way back in the trees, like that one right there. Oh, just kidding. He took off. Oh, man. Oh, it's a redfish. Not interested. Trees. Found our little dink, came out of the tree there. I've been throwing out so many fish and just everything's just turning the other direction for whatever reason. Come here, bud. Whew. Got him. What a giant. Little 14-inch snook there. Another species to add to the list today. Haven't had anything pull the drag, so we can't test the Vanford in that way, but feels smooth so far. Super light, incredibly smooth. I mean, that's what you gotta expect. But I'll keep going here. I just trying to find something decent that'll pull the drag.
Triple tail on this one.
Oh, went down right on it.
Did you get it?
Oh, I lost my shrimp. Shoot. Found a triple tail. All right, so we're back to messing with some triple tail here. And I found a triple tail on this buoy. First cast out, oh, I think he got it. Yep, got him. Ooh. What I was saying is first cast, my shrimp fell off, and I was like, oh, dang it, because he chased it down, and he probably ate the shrimp after it fell off the jig head, but here we go. This one's a little bit bigger than the last one. Oh, swing him in here. Oh my god, it's spinning. That was pretty neat. Second triple tail of the day right there. That's so cool. This one's a bit more yellow than the last one, the one from this morning. Like I said, when they're small, triple tail tend to be like this yellowy color. This one's a bit more yellow than the one from Earth. Ow. Super sharp. These guys are not big enough. I'm pretty sure to keep them, they have to be 18 inches. Pretty sure it's 18. This guy's probably only like 10, 11 inches, so not even close. All right, second of the day. Going back in the water here. Gonna head back to his buoy. There he goes. That's so cool, man. I've never gotten really the chance to target triple tail. And they're such a cool fish. Check out these buoys over here, see if we can't find a big one, man. These ones, these little guys, seem like they're just hugging the bottom of these buoys or whatever. Whatever these little markers are for, but... Got another nice triple tail on this one. And pull one close. Yep. Should see this one. Yep, went right to it. Eat it. Oh, he got it. Got him. Oh, this one's better. They're all over the buoys, man. Oh, this one's pulled a little bit. This one's a little bit bigger. This is cool. This is way better than the sheep's head. They are tough to see, man, when they snug right under those buoys. This is way better than sight fishing sheep's head, sight fishing triple tail. Come on up, bud. This one's definitely the biggest of the day. Triple tail number three of the day. Pink jig right in the corner of his mouth there. See how long this guy is. He's about, see, that's 11 inches. They gotta be 18 to keep, so not quite there yet. But I'll take this. I plan on just coming out here and catching sheep's head and whatever bites, and this is definition of fishing for whatever bites. Number three. I've only caught four triple tail in my life. That's the fourth one. Three of them have been today. Not too bad. That's a nice one. Oh man, I was kind of upset at myself because I pulled up on this buoy right here and I got a little bit too close and the triple tail shot off and I was like, oh man, I can't believe I just did that. This is the biggest of the day for sure. I was so mad at myself because I thought the triple tail spooked and he ended up coming back up top, chill on the buoy, and that was perfect. Took a while for him to eat. He followed the shrimp right off the buoy, 15, 20 feet, and then boom. All right, get in here, buddy. Get in. Oh, that was not too bad. I know these guys aren't giant triple tail or anything or eating size, but a lot of fun because I was not expecting this today. 12 inches. That is the biggest of the day. The last one that I said was decent size was 11 inches, so 12 inch, ain't too bad. They're getting bigger. Look at that face. Pretty cool looking fish. See ya. Not too bad. Reel's doing solid. I know I haven't put it, you know, through the freaking like a big snook or anything, but it's been getting slapped with salt water all day, so we'll see. We shall see. All right, guys. Well, we are currently heading back in right now. It is like 3 o'clock. We spent a lot of time out here, but we got to do kind of what I wanted to do, which was just test out the Vanford, see how it feels. It definitely feels smooth. It feels light. Durability, you know, only time will tell when it comes to those things. But we got done
what I wanted to do, which was basically just catch whatever bites out here, which was what, snook. We got triple tail, that was super cool. We got a sheep's head, just a bunch of cool stuff. And yeah, if you guys are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button as well as hitting the like button. And yeah, let me know what you guys want to see more of here coming soon. I'll be making a lot more videos once summer starts and once spring break gets here. And my camera should be coming in here soon, so we'll stop using this little tiny camera. And yeah, that is gonna be it for today, guys. I will see you guys in that next video. See ya.